Hello and good morning, Walt. How are you doing today?
I'm good. Errol, how are you?
Absolutely fantastic and very excited to talk with you because I don't know what it is about Freddie and everybody else in the band Queen, but it can't be an age thing. There's just something very spiritual and connected to this universe that I can't let go of, and this concert adds to the excitement of loving this band.
It's my life is part of it, and the Magic Carpet Ride is so much so that we're making a documentary about it, which is mind blowing to me. But yeah, I think you hit it. There's something otherworldly, spiritual, and I just think that's what art does. That,
yeah,
I believe. Art can transform you, and then you put the human element onto it, and extraordinary things happen.
Did you know at the time that you were hanging out with legendary performers that would last well beyond you and I?
I don't think anybody knew that.
Okay.
Back then, and I've stayed. In the music business. I mean, I entered the business when I was 22 years old, and I've stayed in, and I'm 65 years old now, and I managed Don Felder, formerly the Eagles. I managed Carolina Boy, Edwin McCain.
Yes.
So it puts me down in your neck of the woods a lot. Edwin's my client and a dear friend. And these conversations are ongoing, and one of the other documentaries I'm involved with is going to be called Tonight We Are Young. It's an examination of what happens at these shows. What happened? What makes these things last forever? I mean, there's rock and roll bands. I mean, watching this film, and I hope you see it this weekend. If you haven't seen it already, I encourage every rock fan to see this film on IMAX because it's a band. Queen at one of the greatest bands ever to do it.
Yep.
At the peak of their powers. You can argue, you know, fans love to argue, wow, that jazz was the highlight, or you know, they have their favorite records, you know. Some are like, wow, they peaked on the second record. You know, Zeppelin fans do it. Beatles fans do it. Stones fans, they pick their spot. Springsteen fans, you know, it's like, you know, this was the highlight. But you watch Queen from 1980.
Wow.
But this was just two nights. It was filmed two nights in Montreal at the end of a very long world tour. And yet the performance is transcendent. Fred is otherworldly Fred's larger than life anyway.
Yeah.
And then on a 30-foot IMAX screen, forget about it. It's unbelievable. It's like nothing I've ever seen. I've seen pretty much everything. Oh. And yet, I was blown away. I saw it on the IMAX screen the other night. They were kind enough to do a preview for us. And I was floored. Floored.
You know what's really interesting about this, Walt, is that it's almost going to be like we're sitting in your shoes or standing in your shoes because you've been on that stage and those cameras are going to put us on that stage, on that IMAX screen, and we're going to feel like we are right there, either as a roadie or just, by God, we were a good radio listener and we won a contest to be on that stage. That's what I love about what you guys are doing with this.
It's even more immersive than that. I mean, I stood on that stage while they were filming
Yes.
these shows, and I have also seen this film before in a smaller format. It came out on DVD 20 years ago, and I bought it and you know, put it in and said, "Wow, isn't that great?" My name's in the credits, misspelled like it was 20 years ago, and isn't that cool? Watching it the other night, I told you I was floored. I was astounded, and I thought surely it's because I'm so involved.
Wow.
But there was a dozen other people in the screening. Some of them, my friends, most of them had not seen Queen with Freddie Mercury. One guy had seen Fred. He was a young the guy was a young teenager, on the Hot Space tour in 1982, and he said, watching, and he's seen Queen with Paul Rogers. He's seen Queen with Adam Lambert a few times.
Yes.
In some special places. He said after seeing this film, that was the greatest Queen experience he's ever had.
Wow.
Because he felt like he was on the stage with them, not just in the audience. That's what the scope of the screen does, and the sound is perfect. And the performance is raw. I mean, if you're a punk rock fan or a heavy metal fan, go see this.
Especially on that IMAX screen, because the sound is so wide.
Yeah, you're immersed.
Yeah.
You're immersed. It's overwhelming. Everyone will have the same reaction. It's kind of, like watching... You know, people in the 50s watch a 3D movie for the first time. You see everyone at the same time all jump. It's the same. No matter where you are in that IMAX theater, you're going to feel like that movie was made for you and you alone. I encourage every rock, every music fan to go see it. If you're a musical theater fan, go see it. Because the power of the performance, all four of them. I mean, these are also not only a band at the peak. Thing that overwhelmed me and was surprised me is watching these four guys who I love. I mean, I toured with them for 2 years. I'm still close with Brian May, and to watch these four guys I love in their prime. I mean, they're in the early prime of their lives, and doing the thing that they do. It's just on that level. It's extraordinary.
Is there any footage of conversation? Because I love listening to Brian's voice and I love Freddie's voice. But or is it just strictly 100% the concert?
It's all concert. It's a straight concert.
Oh my God! It's going to feel like we're right there. Then
opens with the drone that starts the show.
Yes,
and ends with the crowd cheering as the band goes off stage. Straightforward. There's no B-roll. There's no backstage. There's no voiceovers. This is a show. Go ready for a show, and you're going to get your socks blown off. It's an amazing thing.
I love watching these concerts inside like an IMAX, and the reason why is because people don't sit still. I love that when they jump up, they're singing, they're dancing, they're moving around, and it's just such a sense of freedom when you see one of these concerts. So to see Queen in concert, I can't wait to watch the people as well.
Yeah, you have to go see it. It's a tremendous experience. I can't wait. I'm gonna see it again this weekend. I'm gonna see it tonight in Los Angeles, and then tomorrow night in Phoenix. I can't wait. I'm gonna be with friends tomorrow night. That's gonna make it even more special.
And what's great about this, Walt, is the fact that so many people are still addicted to that scene in the movie Bohemian Rhapsody, where they did the concert scene at the end. But this gives them the opportunity to see it, because not everybody got to see Queen with Adam Lambert in concert. Go see the original. Go see why this is why it's even happening.
As great as that was, and that was great. I mean, that when I saw Bohemian Rhapsody for the first time, I was in tears.
Yep.
During that. They got that so right. That is a pale imitation compared to what you'll see from the real thing. Especially if you love Bohemian Rhapsody,
mm-hmm.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
I love that kind of rock attitude. That's what it's all about, Walt.
That's true, man. Wait, ferocious. You'll see.
Dude, you got to come back to this show anytime in the future. And the reason why is because I want to talk about Edwin McCain sometime, because he became a part of our radio show so deeply. And what you have learned and what you've done with music, I want to be able to share that with people, because you are a part of the real story of music.
Well, and I'm so proud to be part of it. And Edwin's touring with other sons of the Carolinas, Hootie and the Blowfish.
Yes.
This summer, along with Collective Soul, coming to your town, and new music. There's going to be a new Edwin McCain record out this year, and so we'll definitely be talking about.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
Well, you be brilliant today, okay, sir?
All right, man. You too. Thank you.